of PQT for T positive. Okay, this is norm. So it is a positive, so this is somewhat looks as the Banach contraction principle what we studied in metric spaces, norm linear spaces, etc. Okay, and two metric spaces also, but you don't have the idea. Like he was mentioning about the Lorentz-Higgs, Higgs and Varusha Reed, okay, they have done lot of contribution, but long back, not recently. They have done before 2000, around 90s they have done very well, when I was actually the research scholar. At that time they have done very well. So Professor Doren, he will talk on this issue, okay, he will see that what kind of theorems are there. He will explain the theorems also, and if you have any doubt actually, so you can directly interact with him, there is no problem. He is very nice to explain you all the doubts, okay. And among us, I welcome Professor Vinayak S. Chaudhary. He is from Howrah. It was earlier the engineering college when I know him at that time. And now it is converted into a university, technical?
Central institute
now, okay? So it is just adjacent to Howrah station, just you can walk down, when you come out the Howrah station, you just walk down right hand side, you will find the place where actually he is working, okay? He is also very good in fixed point theory and applications. He has lot of contribution in fixed point theory. So the next lecture after the tea, he will take that next lecture from 12 p.m. 12 noon onwards, 12 noon to 1:30. And one more announcement for the all the participants, okay? So for you all, the lunch is organized here for today, tomorrow and day after tomorrow also in the same guest house. Those who are going for the guest house, they are fine. Those who have not gone yesterday, they have the lunch in the guest house, okay? So once the lunch is starts, you proceed there, and again the next session will be at 3. That 3 o'clock session is very, very important. I can say that that session is somewhat the brainstorming session. That is, the difficulty raised by you people will be answered by we three, Professor Doren, Professor Vinayak and me. Okay, we shall address. And if possible, some of you wants to say something, you can come forward. Like Professor Dore yesterday asked some of you that you have done something related to the one property using the T norm. So he asked you, he has actually handed over the pen and asked you to do it here. That is also a very nice way of participation of the students along with the expert. Okay, so thank you very much. I request Professor Dore to please go ahead with his talk on fixed point theory in Banach probabilistic metric space. Thank you.
The fixed point theory in probabilistic metric
started with a paper of Segal and Baruchar Reid in 1970s, who tried to transpose this inequality in a probabilistic setting. Namely, they transposed this inequality to the standard probabilistic spaces. Recall that this space is defined by the probabilistic metric is given by this, well, we have X then metric space. Let's transpose this inequality and find FY of KT. By definition, this is a definition, and by this inequality, and due to the fact that epsilon 0 is non-decreasing. This is greater than epsilon 0 kT minus kD xy. Okay. This is k. This is the same with epsilon 0 d minus d, which is exactly okay. Then one obtain this inequality. This kind of contractions on you know that the induced probability symmetric spaces under the T-norm Tm, the T-norm minimum. And then transposing this inequality to arbitrary probability symmetric spaces, one obtains the so-called B contractions, probabilistic B contractions, or Segal contraction, because Segal was the first who introduced this contraction in his PhD thesis. In the first part of the lecture, you talk about Segal contractions, and some other connected with this type of contractions, and then about another important class of contractions introduced by Higgs in 1985. They are given by means of an implication, namely, if X F T is a probabilistic metric space, a self map of X is called Higgs contraction. If the following implication holds for all nt greater than 0, fxy of t greater than 1 minus t implies fxfy of kt greater than 1 minus kt for a given k. From 0, 1. This is the contraction satisfying this contractivity condition are called Higgs C contractions. About here is of course K. This is that doesn't work.
Professor.
This is a definition of a B contraction for some subunitary K. This inequality And the first, the initial theorem referred to the polarisymmetric spaces, actually to Menger space, probabilistic Menger spaces with probabilistic having values in D plus under the T norm TM, as I have already mentioned. And in this case, if the space is complete, you know what this means. Does mean in this case every B contraction has a unique every B contraction is a Picard mapping, that is it has a unique fixed point which can be obtained by the approximation method starting from every point of X. Later on, a little later on, Sherwood has very, very profound papers in polarisymmetric spaces, very, very good, only a few, one or two. Construct B contraction on a complete Menger spaces endowed with T norm TL, with Lukashevich T norm, without fixed points. And from this paper, of course. There was a very important problem, very important challenging problem, to find the class of T norms with the property that every B contraction in complete Menger spaces under this T norms have a unique fixed point. This will denote this class by TFPP, this class contained all the T norms with the property that every back contraction on a complete Menger space or a complete Menger space X under T has a unique fixed point. You know, you already know that TM is here from the theorem of Segal. Okay? And in 1978, Olga Hadzic identified a class of continuous T norm. You have the T norms of Hadzic type. We already discussed about this, and she proved that these T norms are here. The theorem 1-2. Is about the fact that the T norm of Hadzic type has the fixed point property, but is a little reformulated. The theorems of Segal and Hadzic referred to Menger probabilistic spaces, and this theorem is in probabilistic metric spaces, and for the existence of the fixed point, you only need this condition that for an x, f x to be in D plus, not all the and This theorem has been given by Ioana Strățescu. The first theorem in about B contraction in generalized probability sigmetric spaces, not in Menger probability sigmetric spaces. And now I would like to show you two proofs of this theorem, which are related to the class of pseudometrics and the metrics we discussed yesterday. The first one is based on a fixed point theorem in complete generalized metric spaces. Generalized metric spaces are metric spaces, but the value infinity for the metric is allowed. Okay, and here is the theorem of Young. If XD is a complete generalized metric space, and T is a strict contraction, this property, and moreover, the sequence of iterates converges to. To the fixed point of T, which is unique in this set. And another classical deterministic fixed point theorem you'll use, mass theorem, which is a fixed point theorem in uniform spaces generated by a family of pseudometrics. If F is a strict contraction in every pseudometric, and these pseudometrics are finite, then you can obtain a fixed point. This is a Monas theorem in generalized. And now it is you know that the fixed point, the Banach fixed point principle is a consequence of Segal's theorem, but it's surprising that, and the converse is also true. Therefore, the Segal contractions are in fact Banach contractions in a suitable probabilistic metric space, starting with suitable probabilistic metric space. And the first proof shows that in fact you can consider the Segal contractions as Banach contractions. In this proof, you consider the metric DF from the preceding lecture, defined by F is given in delta plus df of xy. Yes, this is the infimum of positive A's, is the property. Is greater than f of t for all real t, it is sufficient for every positive t. And you use this metric for this particular choose of f. Okay. It is better in D plus. Okay. So this T is defined by means of a strictly increasing sequence converging to one, and another sequence of A's in this manner. And let's say consider here is the f here, yeah. Okay, and it can easily be proved that if f is a big contraction in s ft, T here is a tenor of Hajitsch type. T is a tenor of Hajitsch type. You know that the tenors of Hajitsch type can be characterized by having a strictly increasing of idempotence converging to one. They are exactly this are chosen for this sequence. Okay. And if you consider S F T, then and F be a big contraction on x, then f is a df contraction on x with df defined right here. It's immediate. This is here is the proof. You prove that if dxy is less than an arbitrary epsilon, then d fx fy is greater than k dx. This is less than epsilon k for every epsilon. This is based on the fact that the f of xy implies f xy epsilon t is greater than epsilon t. For every t, according to this definition, and if f xy t greater than f dt, then so every big contraction on a Menger space endowed with a tenor of Hajitsch type can be considered as a Banach contraction in a suitable metric space, and if the Proyse metric space is complete, then this space, the metric corresponding metric space is also complete. Now applying moreover, it is easy to see if x f x f of I x is in D plus, as in our case, then df, then dx f for this particular x is finite, and you can apply Young's theorem to obtain the fixed point. Of course, it is unique only on this, on this set. As Young's theorem says. Okay. And the second proof is based on Monod's fixed point alternative. I choose this proof because you already know about this family of pseudometrics generating the F uniformity. Namely, if you consider I have now the definition here. I want to recall the definition of the pseudometric Rn. If you remember, is defined by okay. This is and you already know this kind of implication. You have proved actually this implication from here. It immediately follows that every big contraction, that every big contraction is a Banach contraction in every with Rn with the same k. Here is for every n, and you can apply Monod theorem because all this are finite. Actually, they are less than one, as we already know. Here is a. What you know till now, that the class of T-norm with FP property contains TM and the class of T-norms of Hajish type. This is already in here. That you know that the class of T-norms of Hajish type is here. What is surprising, Professor Viorel Radu proved that if in the case of continuous T-norms, in fact, this is my notation. T probably. F it is does not any sense. T. Say T. That effect T F P P is H. Is H. They are not other continuous T-norm having the fixed point property. That is, with the property that every complete Menger space over D, every has an unique a fixed point because the uniqueness follows immediately. This is a very very strong result of Radu. He solved the problem of t-norms having the fixed point property in the case of continuous t-norms. Okay, and here I only want to sketch his proof. It is based on a lemma of Sherwood. He proved that for this particular Menger space, this is a Menger space under TL effect. Now, it is this space is based on the result of Sherwood, and this is a lemma of Radu. Sherwood considered only the TL here, not an arbitrary continuous t-norm. But it's very just a slight modification of Sherwood's proof led to this lemma, namely this space X and with this is a probabilistic probabilistic metric on this space, and the mapping A in defined the shifting map is a contraction inside, obviously without fixed points. This is a big contraction. It's a big contraction on this space without fixed points, without any fixed point. And now, if T is a t-norm which is not of Hajish type, then this particular complete Menger space from the preceding lemma has a property that that contraction is is a big contraction without fixed points. Okay, this is a contraction of. This is a contraction of. This is a definition of F. Okay. Now, the problem of the problem of contraction under t-norm of Hajish type being solved. Of course, would be interesting to find class of contractions having fixed point under t-norms in probability metric spaces under t-norms weaker than Tm or different from t-norms of Hajish type. And here is such a class, the class of so named epsilon lambda contractions, defined by means of this implication. Here, they are called epsilon lambda contractions because in their definition, appear epsilon and lambda. And it can be proved that every such a contraction has a fixed point, more generally in for that every such a contraction has a fixed point if you consider Menger spaces under PL, or more generally over G convergent T norms. Okay, that are we will discuss it in the tutorial. What is the connection of every epsilon lambda contraction? This the class of epsilon lambda contraction is included in the class of B contractions. This is a special class of B contractions having fixed points in Menger spaces under TL. Okay. Actually, you can consider generalized metric spaces, and such a condition, very 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 weak condition, to move the space of Poincaré metrics to be different from epsilon zero, and the function equals zero everywhere. Okay. In connection with B contractions, of course, you have to speak about some generalization of B contractions. Naturally, by analogy with P contraction in classic in deterministic case, here Professor Murthy already discussed about such class, some class of such contractions. This is the contraction condition is given by means of a function phi. A function phi having values in zero, but it is important to mention this because this is a little difference about here in zero. The value zero is allowed. Zero is allowed. This is a Browder condition. It has very all the good condition, increasing, right continuous, the Boyd one condition, and this one is very interesting, the Matkowski rules. This is a Matkowski condition, where phi is considering B increasing and satisfying this condition for all T, for all positive T. All these contractions have a unique fixed point, incomplete if they are considered incomplete metric spaces. Okay. And I would like that just a few words about this class of contractions of Matkowski-Rus type. Here is a condition of monotony of phi is required, and it is mandatory. Because this nice example of Matkowski and Nish shows that there exists Matkowski fee contraction in complete on complete metric spaces without fixed points if f is not illicit. This is a very, very nice example. Maybe if you have time, we will discuss at the tutorial. The very nice construction. Okay. What is the analog in the probabilistic case? If you, as in the case of B contractions, you will put phi here. Put phi here. And surprisingly, this kind of contractions will be called probabilistic phi contractions because of this phi. And the analog of Matkowski sounds like this in theorem 2.2. Here you can obtain a fixed point for phi contractions in under these conditions. Phi is positive and less than t, strictly less than t for t, and this condition. The monotony is not required. The monotony of phi is not required. And another fact, here we have, if you remember, generally, the value zero is allowed. Why this is strictly, this inequality is strict? I want to show you. What happens if for some then okay. This is from the contraction condition, you have this inequality. This is zero because f of zero is zero. This should take place for every x and y, particularly if x equals y. Why? You ignore this. You obtain is reversed. Here is 1, and here is 0. This is impossible. This is the probabilistic metric setting, phi is not allowed to be zero. Okay. And here, the first proof of this theorem is from 2010, and it was given by Yachimsky, it is a correct pronunciation, and he only only slightly modified proof of Chirich. I like to call this type this theorem, not this theorem, this theorem to Yakimski-Chirich theorem. Although Yakimski was who correctly proved.
There was some mistake.
A little mistake, but the proof is the same. If he, the proof was the same. Here are a version of this theorem in general. This theorem was proved in Menger spaces. Yes, is a version in generalized metric. Generalized probabilistic spaces, and in the case of non-Archimedean probabilistic spaces, even this condition can be maybe dropped. Okay. Yes. This is okay. About Higgs contractions. They are defined by Higgs. I've already mentioned this this definition. And Higgs proved in 1985, Higgs proved that every such a contraction in a complete Menger space under TM has a unique fixed point, but using a very, very interesting method. Namely, he showed that this contraction is a Banach contraction in the space. Of course, recall that the T norm is Tm here, and in this case, every C contraction is a Banach contraction in the space xk, where k is a key fun. We discussed about this metric. It is defined k supremum k. We discussed about this, but it was denoted by D, not by K. It's a Kifan metric. Not exactly this one, but something very, very similar. Okay. And, of course, this metric agrees with the probabilistic metric in the sense that kxy is less than t if and only if fxy of t is greater than 1 minus t. This was the first time in 1985 when the C contractions appeared, and of course the problem was, can you replace TM with a weaker T norm. And almost immediately, Professor Radu showed that instead of TM, we can consider TL. If you remember, you showed that K is a metric if the space is endowed with TL. We have the proof here. Okay. And moreover, Professor Radu proved that actually the T norm TM can may be replaced with every T with a weakest condition to ensure the existence of the epsilon lambda uniformity, that with a property that sup and here is his proof for this is theorem 3.1 in the same year in 1985. And this is very easy to. I will explain what is the. In fact, I can show you now why it is possible to prove a theorem under every T norm, because. Look, if recall the condition is the following: f x y greater than implies and this condition always happen is satisfied for t greater than 1. If you choose such a t, you have that fx, fy for all xy, and again by induction and from here it immediately follows that the existence and the uniqueness of the fixed point, because this condition is very strong. It always this condition is always true for t greater than 1. Okay. And of course, based on this here, choose T1 plus epsilon. And starting from this, obtain this. And we prove that every fixed contraction is uniformly continuous, etc. This is a proof, yes. Okay. The proof. Now, of course, we already have two classes of contractions. They are distinct, because you know that there exist B contractions over TL without fixed points, the result of Sherwood. They are different. Okay, and finally, I would like to speak about weak Higgs contractions. I here point it in, out again. This property, this boundedness property, and here was in 2005 the definition of weak Higgs contractions. Definition of weak Higgs contractions. Here we slightly modified the Higgs condition with and replaced it with the following implication. T in 0, 1, fx y of t greater than implies greater than 1 minus kt for some k in fixed k in 0, 1. Okay. T is not allowed to be greater than that 1. As in the case of Higgs contractions. Okay. That was the condition of here. T is only in 0, 1. Okay. And the first theorem was about such kind of contraction under TL. There are also Banach contractions in the space XK. Kifan K is the Kifan metric. But it was something different because this class strictly includes the class of Higgs contractions. Okay, and here are some examples. Maybe we'll discuss these examples at the tutorial. I want only to discuss this kind of example. It is an indirect proof. It's not. I will not prove that this is a just to remember what I have you have here. Yes, we will prove only that it is a weak Higgs contraction, now it is not. I was thinking about something different. Sorry. Let's discuss this example. Is the space? No, I think yes. Here, zero infinite, and f zero for okay. It is defined only for positive t on the right. We work only with the right side because it is constant, maybe practically. Okay, for x y y, if x equals y, this is 1.
Or no? X equal y equals 0.
Okay. If x equals, it is not equals. Because this is not necessary for all x, y. Okay? This is a complete Menger space under the triangular norm TP. Sorry? Min sub over max. It should to be in 0-1. Okay. Min over max. And this this is borrowed from phase metric spaces. This first appears in the context of phase metric theory. This is a complete Menger space under TP. This is proof in a paper of Gregory and Marinas. And this mapping, given by zero if x, no, we are here in zero infinity, is a weak Higgs contraction. Is immediately to see, but surprisingly, it has two fixed points, 0 and 1. Therefore, it cannot be C contraction, because there you have unicity. It can be B contraction, because there. No, B contraction, it can be proved that a B contraction no, it is not a good argument, because here you are not in D plus, and in D plus you have the uniqueness of a fixed point, but sure, cannot be a C contraction. Okay, because you have the result of Radu. I wanted to speak. Here, another example. Here is the same space, but is zero without zero. And the mapping f of x. Okay. This is a B contraction. Why? This is a B contraction. This is complete. Because fx, fy of kt is always equals fxy of t. Min, max, no. This is a B contraction with if you want with it's a B contraction, but it's not a weak Higgs contraction. Why it is not a weak Higgs contraction? This one. Because we are in a complete Menger space under TP, which is greater than TL. Therefore, you can consider this space also under TL. You already know this. Therefore, F would be weak Higgs contraction under a complete metric space under TL without fixed points, because this one has not fixed points. And the above theorem assesses contrary, that you always has fixed points. If with this condition, you need this condition, which obviously is satisfied because you work here. Okay, a question. This is a big contraction without fixed points. Why it is possible? A big contraction without fixed points in a complete Menger space. There are two reasons. One of them that here the norm is PL. Nothing is. It's possible to have big contraction under spaces with PL without fixed points. And the other one is this one is a generalized probabilistic space. The values here are not in D plus but in delta plus. Okay. You are in delta plus, and the general the theorem about weak Higgs contraction is the following: if XFT is a complete Menger space under a G convergent T norm, then every weak Higgs contraction on this space satisfying this condition has a unique fixed point. And here is a just to scroll through the proof. This condition allows us to find such a delta and to start to such a delta, not necessarily within delta greater than 1. And we have this condition, and then taking here this series is convergent. You apply the triangle inequality here. This is the series being convergent, and for the to prove that the sequence is Cauchy, the sequence of iterates is Cauchy, starting with X is Cauchy. You have to prove that this one is greater than 1 minus epsilon, and this condition is assured by the condition that T is G convergent. This is the idea of the proof. Okay. This is exactly the condition of being G convergent. A T norm geometrically convergent. Geometrically convergent, we have defined this concept. Geometrically convergent. And some references. This is not in the alphabetical order. In 19, sorry, I in 1983, the paper of Radu was in 1985. The paper of Yachimsky about Phi contractions. The paper of Baruch Arayt. And the PhD thesis of Segal. The first result of B contractions appeared here in 72. Although the concept was introduced in 1966. here in this paper for the first time was considered the thinors of Hadrich type. The paper of Radu. And here we introduced weak Higgs contractions and epsilon lambda contractions. And in this paper, appear the results of Radu, both, and about the denoms of FP fixed point property and the generalization of result of Higgs. Okay, this is all for today. If you want to, if there are questions or remarks, please. Thank you, sir.
Hello.